Mississippi to visit my granny and her antebellum world. I'd run barefooted all day long, climbing trees, free as a song. One day I happened to catch myself a squirrel. Well, I shoved it down in an old shoebox and I punched a couple of holes in the top, and when Sunday came, I snuck him in the church. I was sitting way back in the very last pew, showing him to my good buddy Hugh, and that squirrel got loose and went totally berserk. Now what happened next is hard to tell. Some thought it was heaven, others thought it was hell. But the fact that something was among us was plain to see. As the choir sang, "I surrender all," the squirrel ran up hard through his coveralls. Hard leapt to his feet, said, "Folks got a hold on me." Yow!
The day the squirrel went berserk, he first got right to church. In that sleepy little town of Pasadena, it was a fight for survival that broke out into Bible. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!"
Well, Harv hit the aisles of dancing and the screaming. Some thought he had religion, others thought he had a demon. But Harv thought he had a weed eater loose in his Fruit of Looms. As he fell to his knees to plead and beg, that squirrel ran out of his britches leg, unobserved, to the other side of the room. All the way up to the very first pew, where sat Sister Bertha, better than you, watching all the commotion with sophistic glee. Well, you should have seen that look in her eyes, and that squirrel jumped her garters and crossed her thighs. She leapt to her feet and said, "Lord, have mercy on me." As the squirrel made laps inside of her dress, she began to cry and then to confess some sins that would make a sailor blush with shame. She talked of gossip and church dissension, but the thing that got the most attention was she started talking about her love life and started naming names.
The squirrel went to dirt, he first set by the church, in that sleepy little town of Pasadena. It was a fight for survival that broke out in the Bible. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!"
Now 7 deacons and a pastor got saved, and $25,000 got raised, and 50 volunteered for missions in the Congo on the spot. And even without any invitation, there were at least 500 rededications, and we all got rebaptized whether we needed it or not. Now you've all heard the Bible story, I guess, how he parted the waters for Moses to pass, all the miracles God has brought in this great world. But the one I'll remember to my dying day was how he put that church on its narrow way with a half-crazy Mississippi squirrel. They were jumping pews and shouting.